In this tutorial, we'll show you how to use the UI component visibility property to create a modal, a temporary screen overlay. In mobile app development, a modal is often used to display information or gather input from the user without having to navigate to another screen. It typically requires user input and disappears after an interaction. With this app, clicking where it says "click to rate this item" triggers a modal to open and overlay the screen. The app's users can click the stars to indicate their rating and then click the button to submit it. To achieve this, we adjust the visibility of the group UI component in which the modal was built. We want the default setting when the app opens to be invisible, and then we can dynamically control the visibility property based on the user's behavior. Press the T key on your keyboard or click Blocks in the upper left to access your Blocks tab. Let's build out the functionality if the user clicks the rate label. Select it in the component tree and drag and drop the When Label Rate Click block into the workspace. When a user clicks the label, we want the modal to become visible. To do that, click to select the modal group in the component tree, drag the Set Group Modals Visibility block, and drop it within the When Click block. The default setting for this group's visibility is false, invisible, and we want to change it to true, visible. The menu information behind the modal is distracting, so let's see what we can do to make the modal stand out more. Select the screen in the component tree, drag the Set Screens Background Color block, drop it under the Set Groups Visibility block, and select a gray color. And it doesn't make sense for the user to be able to click the Click to Rate This Item label when the modal is already open, so let's change the visibility of that label too. Select the label in the component tree, drag the Set Labels Visibility To block, drop it under the Set Screens Background Color block, and use the drop-down arrow to select False for invisible. Let's check it out. Nice! Now that we're happy with the modal's appearance, let's build out its functionality. Press Escape or click back to editing. Click to expand the modal's group in the component tree. Click to select the Submit button and drag and drop the When Button Click block into the workspace. When the user clicks the Submit Rating button, we want the app to record the submitted rating, close the modal, and return the screen to its default view. Let's start with submitting the rating. Click to expand the Menu Items group in the Components tree. Click Rating Menu Item, drag the Set Ratings Value To block, and drop it within the When Button Click block. This is the rating that appears on the item's details screen. When the Submit Rating button is clicked, we want the value of this menu item rating to be populated by the rating selected in the modal. To do this, click Rating Modal in the component tree, drag the Rating Modal's Value block, and attach it to the Set Rating Menu Items Value To block. Previously, we used blocks to modify the screen's visual design to make the modal more prominent. Now that the modal is closing, we want to revert those visual changes. Click the Set Group Modals Visibility To block above, use keyboard shortcuts to copy and paste it, and drop it in the When Button Click block. But now we want the modal's visibility to revert to false, invisible, so alter this with the drop-down menu. Repeat that for the screen's background color and the label's visibility. We'll change the background color back to white when the modal closes and set the label rate's visibility to true. Lastly, let's give our users the ability to close the modal if they triggered it accidentally. Click the When Button Submit Rating Click block combination and use keyboard shortcuts to duplicate it. Use the drop-down menu to configure it for the X label. The user is closing the modal without submitting a rating, so we can delete the Set Rating Menu Items Value To block. The other three blocks are configured exactly as we need, so no further action is required. Okay, let's test it. Click the Web Preview button or type the P key on your keyboard. First, we'll test the flow if a user clicks the X label. Great! Now let's give the menu item a rating and click the Submit Rating button. The rating has transferred, the modal is no longer visible, the background color has changed back to white, and the Click to Rate This Item label has returned. Excellent! The app's users can submit their rating using a modal that temporarily overlays the main content without having to navigate to another screen. Thanks for tuning in. Be sure to check out our other tutorials and Thunkable Academy courses. And remember, innovation should have no limits.